Hi everyone, welcome back to the next part in our Node.js series. In the last video, we finished our second app, so to say, where we actually rendered some HTML to the screen. Now that is certainly closer to a real website, but still a little bit away. In this video, we'll see how we can target different routes, so different URLs on our page the user might visit. Let's check this out. So I created a new project here, and I only created two HTML files, which will basically be the pages the user can route to. An index file, which just says, well, it works, and a login file, which says the login page. Now, I also got my server.js, but currently I only got the very basics there. It's not even handling the requests. What I want to do in this app here is, I want to create a separate JavaScript files where I will handle the requests, where I will do the routing. So I will create this file now, let's just call it app.js. Now in this file here, I will export a function which should be usable in the server.js, because I want to pass the request from my server JavaScript file, from this create server function here. I want here, the function we're executing here upon each request, I want to define it here in my app.js file. I can use module exports to, well, export the function I want to use. And I will define a JavaScript object which should be exported. And then here I will have a function which I will call handle request. And this will be a function which takes a request and a response. So far, this is the same function we had in our server JavaScript file before, now just in another file. In this function, I first want to set my header with write head, which should well be okay, and should then define the content type to be text HTML. That will be the default if we're, well, targeting a valid route. So this is the first step. Next, I want to somehow check which URL the user entered, so which route I should take and which HTML file should be rendered. I want to have two routes, the index route, which will just be a slash at the end of our URL, so the root directory, and the login route when the user types slash login. So in order to get that path, so we're only interested in the path in our URL, not the localhost part, not the port, not any parameters, just the path. I can use another core module of Node.js called URL, and I require it by, well, requiring URL. And this will give us some helper functions to work with a URL. What I can do here now is I can store the path in new variable path. And then I will call the parse function on my URL module I just imported here at the top. And let me zoom in a bit here. And I will have to pass a string into this parse URL, or in this parse method here. And this should be, well, the URL I get from the request. I can access the URL property on my request object here and pass this into my URL parse method here. Thereafter, I get back an object with several information blocks or with some infos on this URL, and I'm interested in the path name, which will just be, well, either just slash or slash login or whatever the user entered as a route. Then I can create a switch statement here where I say switch the path, and then we get the case that it is, well, just a slash to the root directory. In this case, I want to show the index.html file. Now, I can do this by again reading it in with my file system module and then outputting it in the response and so on. And I will do this way, but I will also do it the same way when we're having the login route and I'm rendering the login HTML file. Therefore, I will create a new function to do this, which you will just call render HTML, which should take a path and a response as arguments. Inside this function here, I'm just going to copy the code from the last section, this here, my file system. and paste it in here. Of course, I have to require my file system here. And then I will just replace this index.html string here with the path, and the rest is fine. The rest is absolutely fine. It's exactly working the way we need it to work. So back here in my switch statement, I can then say, okay, if we're accessing the root directory, I want to render HTML, and here I want to, well, show the index.html file. So I'm specifying the path to this with the dot slash at the beginning. I also have to pass the response, of course. Then I break, and the next case will be that I have slash login. And under these circumstances, I want to also render an HTML file, but it will be, well, the login.html file. Set to response and break. And then I will have a default case. If the user enters anything else, then I want to show, well, page not found. So then I will change my head to say 404, page not found. And then I will output a response where it just say route not defined. And here we have to end the response because when we're rendering HTML, we're doing it in the render HTML function, but here we're not doing it anywhere. Therefore, I have to do it here. So let me save this. And now it would almost work, but there is one thing we haven't implemented yet. And that is, I have my function here, the handle request function, but in my server.javascript, it's not using that. So first I have to import my module here. So I can do this by requiring dot slash, and again, zooming in so everyone is able to read this app without the file extension. And then here I can just call app handle request without parentheses. This is how we create this, and now let's test it. I'll restart my server here and then navigate here. It works. This is the index.html because this is our root route here, just with a slash at the end. So let's check this. It works. Okay, that's correct. Now let's try slash login. It's also working. Let's try anything else, like any route not defined. Great. So this is how we can implement routing in Node.js. And I want to say straight away at this point, I'm doing it with pure Node.js so that you get the basics, that you understand how Node.js works. We will very soon use Express, which is a framework which will make a lot of these things we're doing here by hand a lot easier. Like, for example, writing all this routing code here is not really convenient, right? And if we want to change something, that's it's just not convenient, and we got much better ways to do this when using an actual framework on top of Node.js. But I find it very important to understand the basics too. So that's it on routing. See you in the next videos. Bye.